In this video, we take a look at the top 5 features coming your way in SAP Analytics Cloud. These include Just Ask Natural Language Query Enhancements, Live SAP BW Report Interface, End User File Upload, Unit Handling and Conversion, and Integration with Microsoft PowerPoint. Hi, my name is Orla Cullen, and these are your What's New updates for Q3 2024. Just Ask was launched at the beginning of this year, and in this quarter, we bring you several exciting new enhancements, such as comparison between planning versions, periods or measures, the ability to hide measures and dimensions, to ask questions using dimension properties, and finally, several new permission options. Let's first take a look at comparison questions. In this case, we can ask to see actual client visits compared to the forecast. And we can see that we are 2,600 visits below forecast and that the comparisons are displayed as variances. We can also ask to see sales by country this month compared to last month. This compares time periods for each country. We can also compare two measures, for instance, sales compared to amount not received by products. Next, we take a look at the ability to hide measures and dimensions, and we ask for the average amount not invoiced by customers. So let's assume we don't want users to be able to ask this question or any other question related to the amount not invoiced to customer. As administrators, we go into the Manage Model settings. We open our model, like sales orders, and we uncheck the measure and dimension we want to hide. If we try asking the same question again, we see that amount not invoiced is not in the suggestions and it's not in the list of measures in the model. This is the same for customer. We can still go ahead and ask the question, but as you can see, no result is found. The next enhancement enables users to ask questions using dimension properties. Dimension properties have a one-to-one relationship with their dimension. In the model, they appear as additional columns in the dimension and are also listed in the right panel. Here we see for each bike order ID, we have torque, color, and frame size. In the Manage Model section, the properties are also visible when expanding the order ID dimension. So now we can ask about units sold by color, by frame size, or by torque. And we can also use dimension properties to restrict the answer, for instance, to a particular frame size of 50 centimeters. A popular feature we've offered to BW customers over the years is the Report interface. And we are very happy to announce that Report interface will be supported in SAP Analytics Cloud as of Q3 2024. The first phase of the Report interface will support the following static scenarios: BW queries, external and internal web addresses, ABAP transactions, and ABAP reports. So let's take a look. I open an SAP Analytics Cloud story where I have a table with some sales data. The drill down is defined by country, distribution channel, calendar year, and month. I also have some measures. Let's have a closer look at one of the rows. For example, country US, agent as the distribution channel, and the gross revenue for January 2024. To consume the report interface, no development or maintenance is required in SAP Analytics Cloud itself. This is all done in the BW backend during the sender-receiver assignment. The report jump targets will be offered via a context menu. So if I right-click on a cell and there are jump targets available, they will be listed under the entry jump to. Here, for example, I can jump to the RSRT transaction, I can manage my master data, visit web pages, and of course, jump to BEX queries. In this case, I jump from a BEX query to another BEX query, which will be opened in Data Analyzer. As you can see, the previous data context comes through and I have filters for country, distribution channel, and the calendar year and month. The report interface is available on tables in the Optimized Story Experience and Data Analyzer. We're very excited this quarter to introduce our data file upload. So let's jump in and see this in action. Here in my story, I already have a starter configured. However, I can add one from the file menu by going to Starter and then selecting Data Upload Starter. and it will deploy a trigger on the canvas. If we look at the upload quantities trigger we already created, we can see that it points to a given model and upload job within that model. I can control whether you use the planning area, whether to publish or leave the data unpublished, which target version I want to upload to, and whether I'm going to allow that to be overridden and controlled by the user. In this example, I select the upload quantities trigger and select the file that I want to upload. I specify the sheet and that the first row has header columns. In this case, the first row is not meant to be imported. You'll see that I get a pop-up indicating that the job is uploading, and it'll give me an update on how many records have loaded and how many have been rejected. In this case, one row was rejected out of 9, and I can download that rejected row and see an indicator as to why the record was rejected. Next, we navigate to the model and we see how this upload template job looks. Moving to data management, you'll see a new section called upload jobs, and we see our user upload quantity job. Opening the template, I get the prepared data, a map to facts, and then we can review. Keeping with planning, in this release, we're taking our first step into native support for unit conversion capabilities. So the first thing to note is that we're introducing a new standard unit conversion table, which is a non-editable table within the conversions tab of the model application. We've changed it from currency conversions to conversions. So let's dive in. In this story, we have three measures. These are machine oils in litres, in gallons, and in barrels. Litres is going to be my base measure. I enter an amount of machine oil in litres that I anticipate will be required for producing my bikes. I'll get the corresponding conversion measures for gallons and barrels. I can do this for any of my products, and of course I can enter data on the conversion measure itself. If I want, for the RC002 bike, I need to estimate that one in barrels. I can calculate the corresponding expected use in litres. If we jump over to our model, you'll see that we have a new tab in the modeler application called conversions. We've changed that from currency conversions and we've introduced this standard unit conversion table. If we look at the model itself, I have a measure here, MO or machine oil and litres. I define that as a unit type and it's fixed, and the unit type in this case is litres or L. If I look at my calculations, I now have conversion measures. In my conversion measures, I have two conversion measures related to units. The first is the machine oil in gallons, which is also fixed, and I also have machine oil in barrels. It uses that unit conversion table to do the triangulation between the base measure and the target unit measures. Last, but by no means least, I am super excited to announce our latest SAP Analytics Cloud integration with Microsoft PowerPoint. SAP Analytics Cloud add-in for Microsoft PowerPoint will enable users to connect from your PowerPoint presentations to an SAP Analytics Cloud tenant, and then navigate through your stories, your pages, and your widgets. So let's see it in action. Here I have a PowerPoint presentation where I've inserted some SAP Analytics Cloud widgets containing data from my best run bikes to present the quarterly highlights to the company's top management. You can see some slides I already created that contain two widgets relating to products KPIs. Another one for the sales, and as you can see, I can insert charts, KPIs, tree maps, and so on. Now I'm going to create a new slide with travel information. I select the SAP Analytics Cloud tab from the menu ribbon, and I see that I'm already logged in and connected to my tenant. In the add-in pane, you can see all your recently viewed stories and also those you marked as favorites. I select my story and I can see all the pages in the story, but also all the widgets in the pages. As certain formats are not supported in our initial release, they will be grayed out, for example, geomaps and tables. I go to my travel page and I add the year-to-date travel expense KPI. I get a preview in my add-in pane and I use the add widget button to add to my slide. I can then move, expand, and resize the widget as needed. Next, I choose expenses per department, but this time I want to edit it. This opens a pop-up where I'll be able to interact with the widget, where I can drill down and filter with my interactive menu. In this case, I will remove the drill down and I'll go back to the widget's original state. Next, I will apply a rank for top 5 departments for expenses. Once complete, I can close the pop-up and return to the pane and add to my slide. I can also use all the standard PowerPoint features, such as inserting tags or comments before I share with my colleagues. I can also refresh the data to make sure I have the latest quarterly updates in my slides. This can be done for all widgets in my PowerPoint or can be done individually for specific widgets. I can also then see when each one was last refreshed. Thank you for joining us to learn about some of the top features coming in the Q3 2024 release cycle of SAP Analytics Cloud. Check out the video description for more links to resources about this quarter's updates. And remember to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things SAP Analytics Cloud. Thanks again, see you next time.